Hello friends, I'm Lalita and hearty welcome to my YouTube channel Vivacast. Today we will discuss about chapter 2, Human Body and Health. This is about class 5. This video is for those who are preparing NSO Science Olympiad. So let's get started. Question number 1. Select the incorrect statement out of the following. Spices are obtained from plants. It's true, we get spices from the plant. B. Eating less amount of fiber rich food can lead to constipation. It's also true, if we eat less amount of fiber rich food, it can lead to constipation. Skull has no joints and encloses the brain. This is incorrect because skull has many joints. D. Night blindness is caused by deficiency of vitamin A. So this is also correct. So option C is incorrect. Let us go to next question. Question number 2. In case of fracture, which of the following should be done? Cover the patient with any cloth, preferably with woolen cloth. No, this is not correct. Do not move the fractured part and tie a splint around it. This is correct. We should do this option. Make the patient lie down in a sunny place. No, this is incorrect. Give hot tea or coffee to the patient. This is also incorrect. So option B is correct. Do not move the fractured part and tie a splint around it. This is the first aid. Let us go to next question. Question number 3. Dash nerves carry messages from sense organs to brain or spinal cord only while dash nerves carry messages from the brain or spinal cord to the organs only. Let us see. There are three kinds of nerves. Number 1, sensory nerves carry signals to your brain to help you touch, taste, smell and see. They are called sensory nerves. Number 2, motor nerves carry signals to your muscles or glands to help you move and function. Mixed nerves that perform both the actions of sensory nerves as well as motor nerves. The three kinds of nerves are there. So, which nerves carry messages from the sense organ to brain or spinal cord only? That is sensory nerves, and dash nerves carry messages from brain to spinal cord to the organs only. That is called motor nerves. So, sensory nerves and motor nerves. Here it will come sensory nerves and here it will come motor nerves. So where is that option? That is option C. So option C is correct. Let us go to next question. Question number 4. Identify the part level 2 P, Q, R and S in the figure and select the correct option. So P is skull. What is Q? That is cerebrum. What is R? That is cerebellum. What is S? S is medulla. So where is skull, cerebrum, cerebellum, medulla? That option B. So option B is correct. Let us go to next question. Question number 5. X majorly helps in the formation of teeth and bones. Select the option that gives name of X on unscrambling. So these words are scrambled one. You have to correct them and choose the option. As we know that calcium helps in formation of teeth and bones. This cannot become calcium. This can become calcium. So option B is correct. Let us go to next question. Question number 6. Kavya was asked to write about some actions which are involuntary in nature. She has written some voluntary action too. Pick the voluntary actions written by Kavya from the list given below. Chewing food. First, we should know what is voluntary action and what is involuntary action. So, a voluntary action is under the control of one's will, means under the control of the brain. Example, dancing, eating, writing. If we want to do, we can do. If we don't want to do, we don't do. They are called voluntary. Involuntary action is not under the control of one's will. It is controlled by the spinal cord. Example, breathing, respiration, blinking, eyelids, etc. So, let us see. This is chewing food. This is voluntary. Digestion of food is involuntary. Singing a song, voluntary. Release of acid in the stomach is involuntary. Sitting upright on a table is voluntary. Beating of heart is involuntary. Dancing is voluntary. So, 1, 2, 5, and 6 are voluntary actions, and involuntary are 3, 4, and 7. 3, 4, and 7 are. So they are asking about pick the voluntary actions. Voluntary actions are 1, 2, 5, and 6. 1, 2, 5, and 6. So option B is correct. They are voluntary actions. Let us go to next question. Question number 7. In case of an LPG gas leak in the house, you should dash. Open all doors and windows of the house. Yes, we should open. Do not switch on or off any electrical switch. That is also correct. Do not light a matchstick. That is also correct. So all of these. Which option is correct? Option D is correct. Let us go to next question. Question number 8. Alia's mother called her for dinner. She prepared her thali as shown in the given figure. Which essential nutrient is significantly absent in her dinner thali? Aloo bhaji, okay, carbohydrates, rice, carbohydrates, butter on roti, that is also carbohydrate, and fat also, fruit salad, that is a vitamin. Now, dal is not there. It means protein is missing in the thali. So which option is there? Option A is correct. Let us go to next question. Question number 9. Swati lives in a hostel and has 6 roommates. Out of them, 4 fell ill. Which of them can pass an infection to Swati? Roshni, who has anemia. It cannot pass, this disease cannot pass to other. Sakshi, who has scurvy, this disease also can't be passed. Neha, who develops a dust allergy also cannot be passed. Ritika, who has cold, yes. The cold can be passed to others. So which option is correct? Option D is correct. Let us go to next question. Kunal, a student of class 5, has bow legs. He suffers from pain in the bones of arms and legs, and muscular cramps occurs regularly in him. Select the disease he is suffering from and its causes. So rickets is a disease that is called, and it occurs deficiency because of deficiency of vitamin D. If we take less amount of vitamin D, this disease occurs. What happens? He suffers pain. One will suffer pain in bones and arms and legs, and muscular cramps occurs regularly. So where is that option? The option A is correct. I hope you have enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching the video. See you in the next video.